Once again, a warm welcome to the online class for 10th standard. As in this session, I am going to take social history lesson, that is the first war of Indian independence, which has taken place in 1857. So why we call this as the first war of Indian independence? In the previous classes, we have learned about what are the impacts, what are the strategies these Britishers made to occupy our country. As we can see, this was not going on as continuously. So here we Indians thought to put one full stop regarding the harassment or the force made by these British rules. As we can see, many reasons arise here for the first war of Indian independence. Not only that, here we can see in this lesson immediate reasons for the opposition of our Indians towards the British, as we can call it as a mutiny. So not only that, scope and nature of mutiny, why people started to oppose these Britishers. For many years they were calm and quiet and they are bearing the harassment given by these Britishers, but no one has questioned them. But what is the main reason behind that they started to oppose the British government? And what are the, after approaching towards the first war of Indian independence, what steps they have taken? So whether taken steps successfully maintained by each and every part of our country? No. So as you can see, many failures, and after that failures, what are the results of this mutiny, what we are going to see, and we are going to learn more about this War of Indian Independence 1857. So as we all know, in the previous lessons, as the advent of Europeans to India, the impact of British rule in India, and the extension of British rule in India. So all these three lessons gives us a clear scope. So what is the condition of Indians at that time? So as we all know, in order to extend or to expand their rule over India, so here the British brought many policies like a doctrine of lapse, subsidiary alliance. So as according to these policies, as we can see, many states came under the control of British Empire. Not only that, these policies like subsidiary alliance and doctrine of lapse. As in the subsidiary alliance, as we all know, here the British will appoint one British officer in the Indian kingdom, and without informing or without interfering this British officer, here the king or the queen does not take any decision of her own. So each and everything, military expenses, salaries, and providing each and everything to this British army, everything will be bared by the Indian king or the queen only. So it has become very much burden on that Indian parts. As we can see, many and many efforts were made not to follow this policy, but no one listened to this. As we can see, these Britishers made one more doctrine of lapse. Here means that if the king is not having his own son, so he is not eligible to run that kingdom. So automatically all that kingdoms who have not got their own child, so all that will be surrendered to the British government only. Like this, many kingdoms came under the control of British Empire. Not only that, many people were also upset with the administration strategies of this British. And not only that, the unhappiness created among the people, so there we can see they started to oppose this British government in 1857. So not only that, many of the Indian historians, whoever read and whoever comes to know about this approach, so they used to call as this is the first step towards the freedom struggle of India. Not only that, some of the English historians used to tell this sequence or this situation as Sepoy Mutiny. Not only that, here one by one we are going to see the reasons behind the struggle for first freedom. Not only that, here we can see many reasons are there, political reasons, economic reasons, social reasons are there. So what are that? Why these reasons arise? What is the reason behind this? If you see the political reasons for the Sipahi mutiny, here we can see due to the doctrine of lapse. So here due to doctrine of lapse implemented by these British. So many Indian kings had lost their kingdoms. Why means as they don't have stamina or they don't have that much of army to oppose the British. As a result, they have surrendered themselves and given away all their kingdoms to the British. Not only that, here we can see many kingdoms like Satara, Jaipur, Jhansi, Udaipur and many other states become under the part of this British Empire. Not only that, at that time, Dalhousie abolished the kingships, means he has removed many of the kings from their throne. Not only that, here we can see, as Dalhousie is removed the kingship of Tanjore and Carnatic Nawabs. Not only that, here the British dethroned some of the Mughal kings and many other kings. So as a result, many and many people, not only the common people, even the kings were also upset with the strategies given by these British. So this became the main reason, political reason, for the protest of Indians against the British. So this is about political reasons. Political means here only the kings or the queens has to oppose the government. Here at that moment, here we can see doctrine of lapse or subsidiary alliance made many and many burdens on the Indian kings. So this made the reason for the first step moving towards the struggle for freedom. And moving towards economic reasons, as if you see, many reasons arises there. So one by one, if you see there, economic reasons, financially here, we can see the upliftment of the British and dethroning of Indians. So due to the development of industrialization in England, as you can see, in the 14th century and 15th century, industries started to develop in other European countries. So because of that, here the development of these industrialization in England, the Indian handicrafts and the industries diminished. Means as we can see, kachamal or raw material will be taken by India and it will be exported to England. So there, after making all finishing work, they used to export, import that things to India. So at present in India, all these handicrafts and industries, as ours is hand weaving, or we used to make a number of craft work with our own hands only. So this made much effort on the handicrafts. And not only that, many small industries started to lose their work. Not only that, England, apart from being the industrialized country, so it became the workshop of industries. Means many other countries started to depend on England for the upliftment of their works. Not only that, the artisans of India became unemployed. As you can see, the potter, the blacksmith, the goldsmith, and the carpenter, they started to lose their work. Why means here each and every raw material will be sent to England. So this is the reason here we can see our artisans had got no work in their hands. Not only that, the weavers become the first victims. As you can see, the raw material like cotton and other fabrics which are to be used by these weavers, they started to lose their work because all that raw materials will be exported to England. And not only that, here the weavers, so those who have not got any work in their hand, like for example wool and cloth making industries suffered a lot. And not only that, the Indian handicrafts become financially pathetic, means they started to lose their hopes. So by this, in future, we are not going to get any of the benefit. Not only that, here if any Indian want to start his business, so here the British levied high customs. Yes, they started to levy more tax on the Indian goods, as that goods are provided by us only. But as you can see in the middle, many people are there who have got direct contact towards this British people. They used to send that raw material to that officers, and that British officer used to send it to their England. Like this here, the Indians have got no help from our local people only. Not only that, due to zamindari system, as you can see, even the farmers were also exploited by these zamindars. As you can see, land tax collection made more and more effort on the farmers. Not only that, here the landlords awarded to talukdars, and as you can see in the past and time, here the kings used to award some land to the landlords or to the farmers. So here when the British occupied that kingdom, so here they have taken back all that gifts from the people. Not only that, if the talukdars have got some lands or some awards, that are all taken by these Britishers. So as by forming Inam commissions, as you can see in many of the films you have seen, if anyone plays a drama nice, if any dancer makes the dance, so here the king used to gift some gold coins or silver coins or something to that people. So when these Britishers approached to our kingdoms, they started to taken away all that. Not only that, as a result we can see not only the farmers, here we can see the potters, goldsmith, blacksmith, carpenter, weaver, everyone suffered a lot. So even as a result we can see the farmers had to go under a lot of economic hardships, means their whatever the land they till, so it, in that 3/4 of production will be taken by the British government, and 1/4 it will be sent to the farmer, and in that 1/4 part, so here something should be given to the landlord, and who is the zamindar. So like this, here the farmers felt much burden, and they started to feel insulted by these British people. And not only that, here we can see the involvement of farmers taken much effort in the protest of all these British strategies. Not only that, if you see administrative reasons, why, means how, when as by technique wise only these Britishers occupied our country. As you can see, they not only occupying, they started to insist us, you have to follow such rules and regulations like this, like that. So, but here when you see in this first war of Indian independence in 1857, here you can observe some of the administrative reasons. So here the British brought many civil and criminal laws into effect, as whoever commits a crime, so if he belongs to the British government, so his giving punishment will be different. If the Indian commits that same crime, so he'll be punished so harshly, so that that person is never going to see the outside kingdom or the outside world. Means that much of harassment was given by these British officers. Why, means here there was a total difference in between the English rules and the Indian rules. So if the Indians used to warn that criminal not to continue this once again, or further it, he will not going to continue this. But here if you see the English rules, so even for committing small crime, so that person will be kept in jail for many years. So here even the common people did not like the new laws made by these Britishers. Not only that, if you see the military reasons, but it's very harsh towards the soldiers of our country. As you can see, the Indian will Indian soldiers takes part in all parts of the wars, so that soldier is not going to be promoted for next other promotion. But here if the company has sent many soldiers or some army people, so by seeing there, here we can see the promotion will be given to useless people. And not only that, if you keenly observe the military reasons behind this freedom struggle, the situation of Indian soldiers were worst. And not only that, they did not have any status of their work. So there will be, they don't have proper salaries, they don't have proper promotions. So that was of, if you take Britishers, their consideration is given to that soldiers and promotion will be given only to the British soldiers. Not only that, the pressure put on the Indian soldiers for the overseas work triggered a resentment among them due to their religious beliefs. As you can see, once the British government has sent some rifles, so as you can see here, both the Hindus and Muslims, they used to live together. Each and everyone used to give respect to one another's religion. But here we can see, as in the beginning of this mutiny or the beginning of this struggle, so the Indian soldiers who are present in large numbers in the British army believed that they can drive away these British only if all of us, if all Hindus and Muslims and other religions come together. If you unite together, only we are going to strive away, or we are going to kick away these Britishers from our country. And not only that, here when the British came to know about the unity of this Hindus and Muslims, those they started to play their mind game. So as here the British started providing some guns to these Indian soldiers. As you can see, that guns are called as Royal Enfield guns. So these are all one type of new and improved guns. So as these guns are sent to these Indian soldiers, not only that, when they have sent that guns, one rumor was spread among the people that the bullets of these guns are smudged in a fat pig and cow. Not only that, if you see, if you observe religiously, Muslims hate pigs. And as here, if you see that one rumor was there that bullets were made with pig's fat. It means here that hatredness among these Muslim people made not only just to see that gun, so they are hesitate to touch that gun. But what we can see, the pressure of these British officers were that they have to hold that bullet with their teeth. So means when you hate one thing, so are you going to touch that thing, or are you going to touch that with your lips and teeth? No, definitely we are not going to see. But here the British officers forced these Muslim soldiers to hold that bullets with their teeth. Not only that, if you see, the cow was sacred for Hindus and the pig was prohibited by Muslims. So this was become the immediate cause among the our Indian soldiers not to take part in any of the war further for this British government. Not only that, the rumor of these Royal Enfield guns and bullets so caused a lot of unrest in many places like Barakpur military soldiers. When the soldiers were directed to load that bullets into that guns by chewing, not only holding that bullet with our teeth. So here what that officer is giving pressure means that bullets of the gun will be chewed. One part of the gun should be chewed and it will be again inserted in that gun. So whether it is highly impossible for our Muslim soldiers, so they started to oppose. No, we are not going to break away rules as religious rules were made. Not only that, here by seeing this harassment, we can see a soldier, so who is very dare and dashing in his approach. So when he was observing all these tactics made by these British officers, so here we can see till now, even whoever opposes any wrong ones or any other religious tactics, no, here we can remember only one person, that is Mangal Pandey. You can see one film was also taken in consideration as starring Akshay Kumar and Bobby Deol. So as this, all these religious historical heroes which made us to think and their effort given each and every one to oppose this British. Not only that, if you see that effort of Mangal Pandey, so when he was harassing and making pressure on these Indian soldiers, so here Mangal Pandey shoot at once taken one of the gun and he has killed that British officer. Not only that, so here no one will sit quiet, no. So when Mangal Pandey shot at that British officer, he was arrested and afterwards he was hanged to death in front of all. Means why they used to give publicly death sentence, means here whoever see that the situation, so the person who is having the intensity to oppose this government or to oppose this regiment, so they will have the fear, if I take my step forward, definitely I am going to hanged. How this person was hanged, means they used to create fear among us. But here, not only that, here we can see after the death of this British officer, many of the youth started to approach towards these British officers by opposing not to make this type of harassment on the soldiers. Not only that, here the spread of this mutiny, so made many and many efforts in many places like Meerut, was the major British military base, means as this place where we can see the Indian soldiers live there, and whoever taken as soldiers, they started to oppose, they started to refuse to use these type of bullets made for these Royal Enfield guns. Not only that, many soldiers were arrested when they said no, we are not going to use that guns and bullets. So all that soldiers were arrested and kept in jails. So this made the spread of this mutiny among the soldiers. And not only that, the soldiers barged into the prison and they were kept into the prison. And not only that, many of the prisoners who were inside there for other crimes were released only because of this effort which were made each and every soldier to think about the country. Not only that, this became as the oppose of soldiers, farmers and artisans made the effort. Yes, if we unite together, so we are going to definitely going to make our independence to be taken back by this bondage of these Britishers. Not only that, the seed, so as you can see, the seed for the Indian freedom movement given scope for each and everyone to think, maybe it will be possible. If you put our effort one after one, the strength of one hand to one hand, this is going to work out for further days. Not only that, here a group of soldiers approached from Delhi to Meerut and they entered Red Fort and declared so themselves as one of the Mughal king, that is Bahadur Shah II, as the emperor of India. Means here not interfering any of the British empire, any of the British officer, not asking for a subsidiary alliance. Here they publicly declared that Mughal Bahadur Shah II as the emperor of India. Not only that, so due to some various reasons, here the protesting of soldiers reached Delhi. Not only that, here we can see number of people in different parts of our country, so they started to take part in the Sipahi mutiny. Not only that, here the fire of this mutiny taken lit in some places of Kanpur and Jhansi. So whenever we take the name of Jhansi, so definitely we will remember the name Jhansi Rani Lakshmi Bai. So as since from her childhood, she is having the spirit of opposing that Britishers. Not only that, after she get married to Gangadhar Rao, there she has to face many family problems, and not only that, some administrative problems. But after tackling all these problems, so here we can see Nana Saheb of Kanpur rose in revolt. Means he will stand front to oppose this revolt. Not only that, Tatya Top was his assistant in Jhansi. Not only that, Jhansi Rani Lakshmi Bai provided leadership to this revolt. As being a woman, she is not taken part in any one of the wars. It was not like that in the previous days. Now, at present situations only, no woman is taking part in any of these historic events. If not only that, historic events, if any crime is happening on the road, no woman is going to stop that, and she is not going to oppose that. Why? Means here, because of the environmental effect that women are having. Why? Namage eduku bidu avaravara jagala avaru enadru maadkontare ant anno mentality nalli idivi navu. So here, being a woman, she has taken major control over that revolt. Not only that, to her help, we can see Nana Saheb and Tatya Top came to support her. Not only that, here, after the fall of Kanpur, as that according to subsidiary alliance, here we can see Kanpur was captured by the British. Not only that, if you see afterwards, the spread of this mutiny spread to Lucknow also. But not only that, as these Britishers came to know about the approach of these Lucknow kingdom, so there they took their army, and there they approached and captured that Lucknow, and finally Lucknow fell into the hands of British. Now here the freedom struggle was taken little fire, means ek chingari. So means one lit of fire, just on the venki hachbekandre namge just on the matchstick is enough. So that matchstick was lit by our Indian soldiers, and that fire was moving in different parts of our country. Not only that, here the struggle spread to the south of India. There we can see the soldiers of Rani Lakshmi Bai. Not only that, as the said, according to their strategy, doctrine of lapse. So doctrine of lapse means here the king is not having his own son, so that kingdom should be handed over to the British. So here Jhansi Rani, as even though she'll lose her single son, but again she has taken adoption of from her same family. But this was opposed by this British officer. But even though the people of that kingdom, Jhansi kingdom people, opposed not to interfere in the internal matters of the kingdom. Even though personally Rani Lakshmi Bai also will not give away into the hands of British. Not only that, here we can see she will never accept doctrine of lapse, and she declares war on British. Not only that, she captures Gwalior, and after putting more and more effort in saving her kingdom, so she dies in a heroic death while battling in the British regiment as in one of the battle. Not only that, here if you see the heroic approach of this lady after losing her husband, after losing her son, so in that emotional situations, basically the women will sit in one corner, or they used to sit quietly, and they used to think, what is going to happen to me? I have lost one side my husband and one side my son. What is the basic rule of my life further? But she didn't give up, and she said that all the Jhansi kingdom is my property, as I am the mother of this kingdom. So like that, she has taken the love of that kingdom, and that love and appreciation made her with people of that Jhansi to take more and more parts of her battles. Not only that, here we can see the struggle was good and effort was made. But as you can see, many reasons arises here. So what are that reasons means? Main the failure of this mutiny. So what happens as stepping forward step is good. Here each and everyone are having their each and every strategies how to oppose this British government. But even though this struggle for stepping stone for the freedom struggle kept one full stop or comma. So what is the reason behind that we will see. As the first war of Indian independence failed, as approach was good and the result was also good, but it was failed. Why means due to some reasons. As this mutiny was not covered in every part of our country. So only in Satara, Kanpur, Gwalior, like that only some limited places where we can see the harassment, the not only that, the struggle of these Indian soldiers, we have seen it only in few places. So that's why here we can see that failure was the main reason behind that. Why means here this mutiny was not spread to all over the country. Not only that, it was mainly concentrated on the discussers or the issues and the rights of kings and queens. So means as only some people, some kings used to think that this kingdom is belongs to me. But some people, hey, don't want, naan badkidra saakappa anta. So they used to leave away that kings, kingdoms to the British. So as not only that, they want to maintain their kingship. ಸೊ ರಾಜನಾಗಿದ್ದವಳು ರಾಜನಾಗೇ ಇರಬೇಕು, ರಾಣಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದವಳು ರಾಣಿಯಾಗೇ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಮತ್ತು ನನಗೆ ರಾಣಿ ನನ್ನ ರಾಣಿ ಸೀಟಿಂದ ಹೋಗಬಾರ್ದು, ನನ್ನ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಇಳಿಸಬಾರ್ದು, ನನ್ನ ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಗ ಅದೊಂದು ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಗೇ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋ ಸ್ವಾರ್ಥದಿಂದ ಸೊ ಮೆನಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಮಿಂಗಲ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಸ್. ನಾಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ್ಯಾಟ್, ಹಿಯರ್ there were many unexpected results. Not only that, the mutiny lacked direction, means there is no proper leader to approach all the Indian soldiers, not only the soldiers who are got damaged their professions. They used to take part in each part of this type of mutinies, but here no one came forward. Only some of the people who are taken under harassment, or the people who have got taken into the struggle. Not only that, here the Indian soldiers as only the lacked military strategies, means here step was correct, movement was correct, so after that what next, how to move forward. So there is no leader to give away some instructions. No, there was no proper planning and capabilities, and soldiers were also, they don't have that much of skills to make big strategies. So this was the reason where we cannot see this mutiny has taken up to the peak level. Not only that, here one side sipahis, one side common people will also suffered a lot because of this mutiny. So finally here if you see the result of the mutiny, so here at last the governance of East India Company came to an end, and the governance of British government started, the administration of India. So as you can see that East India Company rights are all given to the Secretary of Indian Affairs, where we can see at that time Queen Elizabeth approached to India. Not only that, here this queen, she has passed a declaration in 1857. As you can see, the effort for the mutiny was put in 1857. All that rights were handed over to Queen Elizabeth. So there she declares one approachment in 1858, and in that approachment, as you can see, one written agreement was given to all the local kings. So what are that means here, the agreements entered by the company, means this Queen Elizabeth comes from the East India Company, and she is having that authority to levy these agreements to the people. So it is written that the agreements entered by the company with the local kings were accepted. So whatever your rules, regulations are there, so you write it in one agenda and send it to us. So which are likable or reliable to us, we are going to accept that. Like this, here the Queen Elizabeth will start making good approach towards the Indian kings and the queens. Not only that, non-constituents of religious expansions. Here, no harassment, no compulsion will be made on the religious thoughts. As Royal Gunfield, which has made both the Hindus and Muslims to think, no, it is not going to put like such type of harassments on the soldiers, providing a stable government for Indians. So here, the Indians will have the government according to their choose. Not only that, equality before the law. As you can see, British soldiers will have one type of law and the Indian soldiers will have one type of law was there. So this is not going to entertain one further times. So all that soldiers and the officers, whoever commits crime, so they are going to be equalized and the crimes, for that crimes punishment will be given equally to each and every people. Not only that, non-interference of the government in religious issues of Indians and practicing religious tolerance. So no officer or no government is going to interfere in any one of the religious aspects. Like if the Hindu wants to make his religion to be popular, he can make. If the Muslims want to make their religion to be popular, they can make. There is no involvement of this British government in religious aspects. Not only that, here the British realized if we command or if we love these Indians, they are not going to cooperate us. So ruling India, it made easy approaches, but after when the Indians realized what is the main reason behind this, so when every Indian started to oppose, if all together combines together and attacks on us, definitely they have to step backward. So keeping in mind here, the British government thought to make a good decision. Not only that, in the instability to listen to the voice of Indians was considered as the main reason for the violence. As if you see, if the Indians will not raise their voice, they are not going to be considered as a struggle or oppose. So here each and every Indian must have that think that we have to struggle for our independence. And not only that, they started to involve all these Indians in the process of legislation and implementation and the policy of association. As this first war of Indian independence, it is like a guide, it is like a forthright picture for the people who struggled for the first step of Indian independence. Not only that, it outlines the importance and alternative adjustment for the future struggles against the British. Not only that, the approach of this Sipahi mutiny or the struggle for freedom independence in 1857 created a little fire in the minds of the British, which made the effort until we get our independence back, we are not going to keep quiet. So as this lesson gives us the first step moving as a stepping stone towards the independence. I hope all of you have understood this lesson. So in the next class, we are going to send the worksheets. Lesson-wise worksheets will be sent. So you have to read the lesson carefully and you have to answer that worksheets and bring it back when school reopens. Have a nice day.